When we have voltage maxima and minima on a transmission line, it means that we have voltage and current waves traveling both towards the load and being reflected by the load. It's the interaction of these waves traveling in two different directions that creates what's called a standing wave. So say, for example, this is the amplitude of the total voltage phasor on the transmission line. And here might be Vmax, and here is Vmin. And the distance between voltage minima is half a wavelength, and here it's also half a wavelength between the voltage maximum. So we know from the load we know that the distance from the load to the first voltage maximum, this will not be drawn to scale, this is 20.4 centimeters, and then the distance from the load to the first voltage minimum is 138.6 centimeters. Therefore, let's see, since this is half a wavelength and that's half a wavelength, so the distance from the voltage minimum to the voltage maximum is a quarter wavelength. So if we find this distance, we'll know that that is equal to a quarter wavelength. I could label this, this is where the first voltage minimum is, and this is where the first voltage maximum is. So we can then find the wavelength would be 4 times this distance between the voltage max and minimum. So we can find 1.386. I'm putting this in terms of meters. Meters minus 0.204 meters. 4 times that. If we calculate that, we get 4.7 meters is the wavelength of the signal on the transmission line.